97.5 WBLS, your number one source for R&B.
It's BLS, two T's in the house. Tell us real quick, how did it start for you? How did it all start for you?
Well, a lot of people don't know, but the first record I made was Went for the Treble with Davey DMX.
Oh, yeah.
Right? So I did that. I went on tour. That's when Andre Harrell was rhyming. So we went on tour when Run DMC's and Houdini and all of those first came out. Uh-huh. So, you know, after that, then I got with Herbie. Love Bug.
Mm-hmm.
And that's when I got with Idolmakers. That's when It's My Beat came out. I got signed to Profile Records, and you know, the story goes on from there.
Wow, because House Money, we talk, and Chic Styles, we talk about the lures of hip hop, and we talk about female MCs. Sometimes your name is forgotten, and it's forgotten when people think about it, but then when you think about it and you think about the records that you've made, like, wait a minute, gotta be in there, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Gotta be in there, right?
Absolutely.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. If you was to do a top three MCs of all time, real quick, who would they be?
Okay. So first I have to say Rakim. That's my boy. Rakim, Biggie, and Tupac.
Top three female MCs. You had to you don't have to really go 1, 2, 3, just name three that you
I'ma say MC Light, Queen Latifah, and Lauryn Hill.
All right. Do you know all of them personally?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
Yes, I do.
I'm gonna name one and just give me a word that describes Lauryn Hill. When you say Lauryn Hill, what do you think about when I say Lauryn Hill?
Lauryn Hill is just like, she's just so talented, so multi-talented, and I miss her. I definitely miss her on the scene.
MC Light.
MC Light, she's just, you know, she just comes with it, you know.
You ever did a show with her? You ever did a show with her?
Absolutely.
Wow, okay.
Absolutely.
Okay, Queen Latifah.
Queen Latifah, you know, we go way back, and, you know, she's doing her thing. She's definitely just, in all areas, just getting it. She's doing her thing.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
What was the most memorable performance back in the day? Like, because everybody talks about Fresh. You remember, like, a thing you did, like say, with MC Light or whatever? Which one stands out to you?
Well, and it's funny because Latifah wrote about this in her book, because she was in the audience that night. Jazzy Joyce and I, we had a show, and we pulled up to the front of the theater, and it was, the marquee was out, the lights were out, and there was a line around the corner. So we were like, wow, we're here, it's not open, you know, what's going on? So, you know, we got nervous, and Herbie, he got out of the limousine, he went in, he came back out, he said, listen, it's so crowded in there that they had to shut the marquee off. And they're waiting on you and Jazzy Joyce to come in and do your thing. They had to have us back there within the next 2 weeks to perform again for those who missed it. So that was one of my most memorable moments.
A lot of people always say nowadays, what's up with the female MCs? What's going on with them? What's your response to that?
I think there are some here. I don't know why they're saying, where are the female MCs? There are some here, and they're representing, and they're doing their thing right now. I love it.
Has anyone up and coming have come to you for guidance or direction?
I mean, anytime they do, like, the game has changed so much, and it's not about, like, a record label driving you right now. It's about you driving yourself, you know, going to the studio, being serious about your craft, and, like, you know, putting it on the internet and, you know, just building your stamina up. So, you know, I just give them that advice. Like, you know, if you want it, go get it.
All right. Somebody wanted me to play It's My Beat over again. So we're going to do it. We're going to do it a little different. So can I get the beat?
Okay.
And you rock it.
Okay.
Sweet Tea style.
This is for you, homegirl.
Sweet Tea Live. Classic flavors. WBLS.
The bass is thumping, the party is jumping. I got the rhymes to keep your body pumping, to keep you rocking, that's what I intend. It's 8 number 1 on the Sweet Tea agenda. I'll break it down so you can see the skillful way I recite my poetry. Quick as a flash, I'll pop up on the scene, break out the Casio and the drum machine. Got to get busy cause I know I'm down, as I tap into my instruments, this funky sound. prone to make your body start to perspire. As I turn the volume up higher and higher, grab my JVC, popping a cassette. Had the people stomping to my beat, you bet. Play it for my friends, cause it sounds so neat. And they ask,
what do you call it?
It's my beat!
Huh? What?
It's my beat!
It's my beat!
Oh, we live. Okay. Alright. Give a round of applause there. That's how we do it live. One of the things I always, when people who have made records over two decades ago and they try to come back and make something, the issue I think sometimes is your fan base wants to hear a certain sound.
Yes, they do.
But then you get caught up as an artist trying to do the sound of today. If put in that position, what would you do? Would you kind of replicate what you did 20, 25 years ago? Would you try to do something now? Or would you try to implement a little bit of both?
What I would do is something that's me. So, like, if I can, you know, like, create my lane that, you know, I've had all this time and just do something that's going to, you know, appease my fans. Mm-hmm. And, you know, do it that way, I would do that. You know what I mean? It's not about, like, oh, give me a today beat. No, give me a me beat. Give me a beat I could flow on.
What is Sweet Tea? What are you? If I define yourself real quick.
Well, you know, lots of times, like, I like those smooth beats. I like those R&B, like, smooth beats. So lots of times I find myself doing that kind of music. Like, you know, and I do some up-tempos, too. But, you know, we're going to work on that, though.
With that being said, who would you like to collaborate with, artist or producer?
That's a good question.
Bent Rock.
Wow.
Bent Rock.
Look, you got me stuck a little bit on that one.
I think he's giving you a hint.
Huh? Okay. There you go. There you go.
Bent Rock has skills.
I need the beats. Mm-hmm. I need the music.
It's a hit
let's
right
do
there.
It. Oh, okay. Let's do it.
All right, but you know, I'm old school. So it's going to have an old school. I'm not ratchet, yo. I'm not ratchet, money. I'm not.
I know.
I thank you for coming through. I really appreciate it. What do you want me to play on your way out?
So, I just want to say one thing. Like, you played my girl Roxanne Shanté. I just want people to know, like, you know, Shanté is nice. She's like one of the only girls I know that, like, she would walk into a party and maybe collect a little bit of information and just like, yo, she goes off the top of her head, like,
I've
at parties on the regular. She's nasty with it.
She did my birthday party years ago back in Philly, and I watched her operate, and I did something with her in Jamaica too.
And then Shanté, Moni Love, Yo-Yo, and I are actually getting together to do a national hair ad campaign for Miss Jessie's. It's a natural hair care line.
Oh, wow.
So we're doing that. We're in the works of that. And, like, you know, we're going to make some moves from there. You know, stay tuned. We have, like, I'm working on a show. And hopefully, you know, I'll be able to tell you a little bit more about it. It's in the works right now.
You can always come back.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
And you mentioned you're going to be performing March 5th in New York, or is that day right? March 5th, March 6th?
March 6th. I'm actually going to be on Chubb Rock set.
I'm there.
I will be there.
Eric King. Okay, yeah. All right. See, I'm the one that plays the music.
Yeah, I know.
There you go.
You know, and I want to give a shout out to my homegirl, Nikki. I want to give a shout out to my sister, Denise, Kimberly, my brother, Neil, and some special people at the Van Wyck facility. My manager, Mike, my publicist, Pearlene. Like, they're really working with me, and we doing some real nice things, you know. I want to thank you for having me down.
Thank you for being here.
This has been really great.
Thank you so much. I forgot Nikki D. You said Nikki D.
We told you, Nikki D.
All right, so mentions real quick. Was it Missy? You said Trina. Who else? Mm-hmm. We miss anybody?
Yeah. You play Salt and Pepper.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, so, you good.
Antoinette.
Oh, Antoinette, yeah. Oh, yeah. Vanessa Sequoia. Oh.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Just pull out the crates.
There we go.
All right.